When you are calling people towards Allah, make sure that with the knowledge that you require to achieve that, you need something very important, and that is wisdom. Some of the scholars put wisdom before the knowledge, and some of them say wisdom is after the knowledge, and some of them say wisdom is after the knowledge but is applied before it. So you learn knowledge, and then you have the wisdom and you apply the wisdom before you promote that knowledge or propagate it. When we preach to people, when we talk to them, when we want them to turn, how do we make them feel? Do we make them feel important, or do we belittle them? If you're belittling someone, you don't have wisdom. You want goodness from a person whom you're belittling, you're yelling at, you're screaming at, you're swearing, you're dooming. This is why we say don't doom the people. You are not the owner of the Day of Judgment. Your job is, before you get to the end, try to convince this person to buy your product. What is it? It is that I want you to achieve success. And I desperately would like to see you in the mercy of Allah. So that's what Allah wants from all of us. And the reason why I make it my duty to convey the message is Allah's kept a great reward for anyone who spends a moment to care for others enough to want to see them rightly guided. So Allah says, one of the best things you could ever do is to spend time trying to guide another person. And if Allah guides that person through your effort, you've made it. MashaAllah, you've made it. SubhanAllah, you've achieved something more valuable than the red camel, which is like the best conveyance of the time. SubhanAllah. So doesn't that show you the plan of Allah? You reconnect with revelation, you reconnect with others, with human beings, to help them connect with that revelation.